It was the 21st of February, 1944, a sunset evening. Squadron leader Arthur Oxlade and navigator Lieutenant Donald Shanks of 464 Squadron prepared to take off on what would turn out to be an almost impossible mission. Their aircraft was the de Havilland Mosquito Mark 6 with tail number MM401. This was, however, no ordinary Mosquito. It's been fitted with an experimental IFF transponder, a device used during the war to identify friend or foe. This transponder has been specifically designed to mimic itself as a Luftwaffe aircraft, appearing as friendly to long-range German radar. They were to embark on a top-secret mission in conducting a tactical strike on the heavily defended V1 flying bomb sites over northern France, Calais. With little to no counters during the night, the German wonder weapon had free realm over England, often regarded as the most fear-inducing creation of the Second World War. They take off from RAF Hunsdon, Hertfordshire, nearing 400 miles per hour as they cross the White Cliffs of Dover. Being constructed mostly out of wood, the Mosquito was one of the first aircraft of the Second World War to fully exploit its stealth properties against radar. Having a very low radar signature and maintaining flight at sea level meant that they could stay under the radar whilst causing havoc in the skies. Accompanied by nightfall, visual detection at range was not likely. Their flight plan was to enter Calais from the south, avoiding as much landmass and anti-air defences as possible. Once at the V1 flying bombsite, they were to conduct a tactical strike before circling back and leaving France the way they had entered. Arthur Oxlade and Donald Shanks only had a 5-minute window before enemy aircraft were scrambled to intercept them. As Arthur and Donald entered France, they spot hundreds of search spotlights, flak batteries, and built up defences around Calais. Arthur Oxlade recalls it as being a hornet's nest, the most heavily defended site he's ever seen. In order to bomb their target with precision, they would be required to enter a slight climb from sea level to an altitude of 250 feet. As they began their climb, a lone spotlight sweeps past the tail section of the Mosquito. They rapidly maneuver to get out of sight. However, it was to no avail. Multiple search spotlights were now focused onto them, illuminating their Mosquito in the night sky. Their cover was blown. With 4 minutes remaining, they had two options: turn and head back home, or disregard the odds and carry on with the mission. Arthur and Donald had flown their Mosquito since 1942. The pair had a very strong partnership, and their aircraft had never let them down. It was vital to the war effort that the V1 flying bomb sites were destroyed. Without hesitation, they continued, determined to successfully complete the mission. 225 Flak 88 cannons defended the coastal city and had their sights set on them. All of a sudden, every flak battery within the vicinity defending Calais opens fire. They swiftly maneuver their aircraft in a weaving pattern at high speed to make it as difficult as they could for the flak batteries to land a hit. No matter how well they flew, Arthur and Donald knew it was simply a matter of time before they were overwhelmed. Spotting the V1 flying bombsite below them, Arthur puts his Mosquito into a dive to gain as much speed as possible on the target. Just as they prepare their attack run, they are instantaneously blinded. The aircraft shudders and begins a hard bank. Startled, Arthur looks starboard from the cockpit to see what had happened. He sees almost half their wing missing. Due to the high speed the Mosquito was travelling at, accompanied by its two powerful Merlin engines, Arthur manages to regain control of the aircraft. Another bright flash. This time, the aircraft begins to rapidly lose speed. Donald, looking portside, opposite to the damaged wing, calls out that their number one engine was shattered, with its propeller and spinner nowhere to be seen. The Mosquito's radio equipment was also shot and no longer functional. Navigator Lieutenant Donald Shanks couldn't call for any assistance. They were on their own, with the entire city of Calais trying to bring down their crippled aircraft. The Mosquito was now flying on half a wing, a single engine, and no radio. Squadron leader Arthur Oxlade knew that the Mosquito was a tough aircraft, but it was a shock even to him that it managed to keep flying relatively well. Having lost an engine opposite to the missing wing, it helped Arthur balance the aircraft to an extent, restoring some of its maneuverability. As a last resort, he engages war emergency power on the single running engine. It was too late to turn back now. Remarkably, they conduct their precision bomb drop on the site as planned, destroying two large hangars of V-1 flying bombs and a command center. Armed with powerful nose-mounted guns, they strafe the site on the way out, destroying multiple anti-aircraft batteries and pillboxes. A sudden thud below the aircraft jolts the Mosquito upwards. A flak strike had just shot off their portside landing gear. Losing the weight of the heavy bombs allowed the Mosquito to gain ample speed. Arthur informs his navigator, Donald Shanks, that their initial plan to head back home, northwest, was not possible. Having suffered vast amounts of damage, any sharp bank would put them at the risk of rolling over. A roll in an aircraft in this condition simply could not be recovered. If they were to crash land in France, it would also lead to the capture of the Mosquito and themselves. Instead, the pair knew of an airbase known as RAF Friston, an emergency landing ground southwest of Dover in England, but they weren't so sure that their aircraft had enough power left in it to take them home. The only running engine had started to boil, losing power by the minute, and with a daunting 30 miles of sea to cross, it seemed an improbable task. Arthur and Donald have never been shot down before. Dumping as much fuel as they could spare, they point their nose west for RAF Friston, adamant on returning home. Miraculously, they manage to limp their Mosquito 30 miles over the Dover Strait and come in for a landing. As Arthur extended his landing gear, he could tell something wasn't quite right. There was a bizarre metallic grinding sound as it went down, which felt abnormal. Regardless of whether or not the landing gear was down, the aircraft couldn't stay aloft much longer. Their only running engine had been exhausted. Unsure as to what the condition of the landing gear was, squadron leader Arthur Oxlade touches down smoothly, but the Mosquito begins to tip portside. Immediately noticing that the landing gear was uneven, he keeps the aircraft centered using his only aileron. They had landed. With the starved engine finally shut off, the pair climb out of the cockpit and take their first look at the condition of their Mosquito. It was a strange moment of silence. Arthur simply couldn't believe that he had landed his aircraft on half a wing, a missing landing gear, and one engine, even managing to avoid a propeller strike. He had requested his aircraft to be restored to flying condition. He was told it would be repaired as Category B. Sadly, he would later find that his beloved Mosquito had been scrapped. The pair had successfully completed 127 missions together without being shot down. The 128th mission, however, would be their last. It was D-Day, the 6th of June, 1944. The largest amphibious invasion in military history. They would take off in a Mosquito Mark 6 with tail number NS897. Arthur and Donald were on a long-range intruder mission to destroy pillboxes and defenses built up on the beach. Their target area was Mayenne, a coastal city in France. Their Mosquito would take a severe hit from flak, setting fire to the underside of the portside engine. They could have turned back around to England at this point. However, knowing that the troops on the ground in the invasion were being hammered by pillboxes, artillery, and light machine guns, their mission was of the utmost importance. The fire is extinguished and Arthur continues, successfully completing their strike on the defenses. Just as they began their return journey, the portside engine bursts into flames. At 1500 feet, their second engine catches fire. The Mosquito begins to lose controllability and starts to roll. Arthur fights with the controls as best he could to keep it stable and screams to Donald, "Get out whilst he can," allowing him to bail out. He saves the life of his longtime friend, Donald Shanks. The war for Donald Shanks was far from over. On the ground, he now had to evade capture. With the help of the French resistance, he manages to escape France, returning back to his squadron in England on the 7th of September, 1944. Although he had been told that Arthur was killed in action, Donald always had a glimpse of hope that his pilot had somehow survived and is quietly living somewhere in the mountains, hidden from all the killing. Lieutenant Donald Shanks would go on to survive the war, returning home to South Yarra in Australia. But he often kept in touch with Arthur's parents, letting them know that he was always asking and looking for him. Donald Shanks never found his peace and passes away in 1983. The V1 flying bomb wasn't the only German wonder weapon of the Second World War. Our sponsor, CuriosityStream, has a fascinating hour-long documentary with well-made CGI animations on the Nazi secret weapons of World War II. These educational, award-winning documentaries, shows, and series are only available to watch on CuriosityStream, perfect for anyone who loves to learn about history and aviation. Plans start from as low as $5 a month, with optional annual plans giving you access to thousands of hours of high-quality documentaries. It's highly flexible, as you can watch these on your TV, computer, and mobile, and there are weekly content drops, ensuring you never run out of content to watch. Go to curiositystream.com/FlakAlley or scan the QR code for unlimited access to the world's top documentaries and non-fiction series. And for our fans, use promo code FlakAlley and you will save 25%. Just click the link below or go to curiositystream.com/FlakAlley and save 25% right now. Please consider becoming a channel member and subscribing to us. In doing so, you directly help in keeping these long-forgotten stories alive. Thanks for watching. Stay safe.